Our next speaker is someone who used to care about a lot about how others think of him and will try his best to mix with the happening crowd. Then one fine day, he wakes up and realizes this is them. Let him tell you more. Chan Yu Chong, I, Chan Yu Chong.
I am Chan Yu Chong. I am a man. And I am a member of the Deal Dharma Toastmaster Club. Honorable Toastmaster of evening, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome guests. A very good evening to all of you.
Good evening.
I is a very special word. I is a very special letter. Or in fact, to be more specific, it's the 9th letter of the alphabet, which can also doubles up as a word, which means me, a name I call myself, as in the song Do Re Mi. Basically, most of the time, when we think of the word I, we think of ourselves. And I actually has a very strong meaning. It has a strong meaning, especially tonight, because tonight I will be presenting my 10th speech from the Competent Communicator Manual, which will give me a new milestone in my Toastmaster journey. And I believe also I being special because I am the one and only. Quite nervous on my 10th speech. You cannot bring away.
Okay.
Basically, from I, when we say the word I, it is a very strong word because it also, because when we add can or able to it, is indirectly we affirm ourselves that we, as a human being, can do something. But if we use it wrongly, like we put a no or not at the end, like I am not, then it defeats the purpose. I often use this whenever I'm faced with some setbacks, such as when I think that the road is quite jammed in front. I will always think that, previously I would think that, oh no, it's going to be very bad, I'm going to be late. But I'm late, but now I'm thinking that, okay, I am able to enjoy my time more. I'm able to give more time to myself, because I'm in the car to myself, so no one can disturb me. This is one of the ways that we can reaffirm myself. And also, because I'm in the sales line, so whenever I go out and meet my friend or meet my prospect, if I want to get a case done, I usually think to myself or talk to myself first before I go over there, and then I tell, okay, I, Chan Yu Chong, will surely get the prospect to get this very good plan for himself or for herself. So this is how I do it, and I believe you all can try it out also. Today I'll be sharing some of the stories that I find inspiring. And this happened to people that is very near to me and also very dear to me. How many of you have been hospitalized before? What about 2 times? Basically, my son was hospitalized 4 times by the age 18 months. First time was due to jaundice. Second time was due to hernia operation. 3 months old. Okay, 3 months old, not 3 years old. Or 30 years old, okay. Then the third one is due to illness, and so is the fourth one. By the time he's 18 months old. And this makes me count my blessing. Because I used to think that whenever some setback happened to me, I would think, why me? Why me? Of all you, and all of them, why me? But now I think that, I see my son having suffered, then I think that, I'm still here, your daddy has not been hospitalized. So it's still a good thing. Okay, although not really that good at all. But if possible, I would rather take this place. Because it's really heart-aching or heart-wrenching, in fact, to see such a small boy having to have a needle poked into his hand and having it put over there for easily 5 days to 6 days. And then also, There was once he cannot even drink water because he has mouser on his mouth, inside his mouth, and also inside his throat. So you can see his lips drying up and then also cracking. This really hard thinking. And it's things that I should count my blessing and not be too focused on seeing the bad thing happen. And the next person that inspired me would be my mother. Why is it so? Because my mother taught me to be a humble person. I used to be a very demanding child when I was young. Reason being, my family is quite big. Even on my father's side, there are already 30 people and more, excluding my mother. My mom's side, another 20 more. So whenever there's a gathering, easily 5-6 tables fill up. And we're talking about KL people. So whenever being from a big family, I'm also one of the youngest in the family. Not youngest. In fact, I'm the youngest in the family when I was born. And my youngest elder brother is around 8 years older than me. So being the youngest one in the family and the boy some more, so usually we tend to get more attention. And what you all do when you all get more attention? You start demanding. So that's what I do as a child. I demand this, I demand that. And then as I grow up, okay, and then when I know more things, and then I get to know my mom also, okay, then I see that she also comes from a similar background to me. She was the only daughter in the family, and also after four elder brothers. So her parents must be really pamper her a lot, like love her a lot, being the only daughter. She could have been me like previously, but then when I know her, she was a very humble housewife. Because in my house, there live 12 people. Okay, we live in a small room only, 5 of us. We live because my father doesn't own a house at the time, so we stay my uncles, my aunties, and also children of one of my uncles who own the house. And my mom basically, in order to supplement my father's income, what she do is she help all the uncles and aunties to cook for them, especially for dinner. Because my house is works something like a hub for the family all to go back in gather at night for them to have dinner. So my dinner starts around 6 o'clock all the way until 9 o'clock. Okay, so it's something like a economy rice store. Okay, you come in, but then it's already all prepaid. So you just come in, they get the dish, normal dish. Okay, my mom will cook fish, veggies, meats, soup. So when they all cook everything done, okay, so they come, the earlier one come at 6 o'clock, they come over here, they bathe, and then they eat, and then they go away. So it all goes until 9 o'clock at night. So by then, sometimes I will help my mom, but usually I don't, because I'm not get used to helping around in the house. Until the day I'm into uni days. Okay, but that will be another story. So now, my mom, other than cooking for people, my mom also has to take care of, also has to wash their clothes. Because in order to supplement, you have to do a lot of things. She also washes clothes for them, for my uncles, aunties, and then also babysit their children, just to earn some extra income, so that me, my sisters, and my parents can have a slightly better life. And the third person that inspired me would be my father. He tells me that he lets me know that if we are committed to our work, it really pays off. It really pays off. This being, he was a very dedicated technician with a Japanese company that manufactures electrical appliances for 25 years. And then after 25 years, one day the company was merged. And in the process of merging, so he requested for VSS when he was offered back then. The first time he didn't get it because they didn't tell the reason, so he just did not get the offer. So, but he was quite disappointed, and he was even more disappointed when his partner or his buddy get the VSS. So, but then this doesn't mind, he just carried on without any remorse. So then the second round, which is a year later, he get another offer, or the company offer another VSS. So this time, he get it. get, and what a joy he has. Yes, because he was, because by the time, because when he get the VSS, he was 6 months to retirement. And usually people, and no company would give you that, would be that good enough to let you do that. Isn't it siwa? If there's someone for you, just faster go, no way. So this makes me think that, okay, if we really put our heart into our work or our career, it really pays off. And then after another 6 months, he has the option of getting his EPF or to withdraw his EPF. So this, from these three people, they have inspired me that being persistent, sorry, we should count our blessing, okay, and not look at the bad things. We should always be humble. Okay? At the same time, we should also be focused on our career path or on our career, or on our work, whatever we do, we should be committed. All these have inspired me, and I sincerely hope all of these have inspired you. Thank you.